Dr. Kalani Brady from the John A. Burns School of Medicine joins us now, as he does every Thursday. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning. How are you?
I am fine, thank you, and I'm glad you're well this week.
Yes, indeed.
Well, we got a double amount of callers in your absence.
Okay.
Well, first off, we're going to start with a caller from Lanai. A woman asks, if it's safe to use those eardrops for wax removal? I guess they're specifically advertised eardrops for that?
Right, and the eardrops in most cases are hydrogen peroxide and mineral oil, and you can use hydrogen peroxide and mineral oil for pennies. The eardrops cost several dollars, but basically those are the active ingredients for cerumen, or wax removal from the ears. So you basically leave them in for half an hour while you're watching a television show, and then go take a shower and let the water hit the outside of the ear, and you can clean the wax out yourself for pennies.
Okay, so don't like force it back out or vacuum it back out, just kind of do it the other way?
Right.
Okay. I was recently put on steroids. A woman called in to ask, is there anything I should be looking out for?
Steroids are very powerful medications, and we use them for serious diseases. There are a lot of side effects with steroids. One that doctors may not think of telling patients is the mood swings. So there's emotional lability with steroids, and the people around the patient that's taking the steroids should be informed about this so that they know it's not the patient going crazy. Other things are increase in hunger, sometimes stomach pains in the stomach region of the abdomen, susceptibility to infections. Long term, you have a rise in your cholesterol and your glucose. All of these things can happen with steroids. But if the doctor recommends steroids, it's usually for something pretty serious.
I am diabetic, a woman asks, and notice light discoloration on her shins. Will that get worse?
It could. Without seeing it, of course, it's difficult to guess at what it is, but it probably sounds like a fancy thing called acanthosis nigricans. So this is a blemish that occurs in diabetics and people with peripheral vascular disease, and if the diabetes is under poor control over time, it can get worse, yes.
A woman would like to know when puberty or pre-puberty starts for girls. She says she's got a fourth grader who is experiencing tenderness around here or has complained of such.
That's common, yes.
Is that the age?
Well, it's usually a little later, but as we have had better nutrition with our children, they grow bigger, faster, and puberty sets on at an earlier age than it did, say, 50 years ago in general.
I don't want to hear that. So I should feed my kid all kind of fast food, junk food to keep her from...
Oh, no, the fast food will actually enhance the fast growth. Good, healthy food is what you want to feed your children. And it's very important not only because they're developing, but you want to have the habits of good, healthy food so that in adulthood they eat healthy choices because that's what they were eating as children.
Oh, Doc Brady, thank you.